Shalom. I want to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rekha HaKodash, double honor to our apostles and elders of Great Millstone who does lead and rule well. Salutations to all you hopeful like Akim, pushing out this word in sincerity and in truth to the four corners of the earth. And sincere shalom to you, Akim and Akwa, for listening and learning, preparing yourselves here in these last days. And to the entire household of faith, fighting this good fight of faith, I want to say shalom. This is your brother Duquar from the DC camp. Come back at you with another lesson. And I'm entitled to this one, The Lord Will Be Our Covering. All right. Now, you're looking at the news as we're supposed to be doing, watching. You see this this new MLTB infrastructure being set up, you know, with this, with the CBDCs and digital currencies. You seeing also, which all goes hand in hand, you know, countries ditching the dollar, all right, and aligning themselves. You know, you got what was it? You know, aligning themselves with the BRICS, the new currencies, Brazil, even, you know, Russia, China. They don't want to trade into U.S. dollars no more, man. You know, which these things has to happen so that prophecy is fulfilled, right? You know, and that's ultimately going to lead into World War III. So, you know, you got hyperinflation going on. You know, you got the collapse of the dollar, the monetary system and the economic system. You know, all that's going to lead to a lot of chaos. But in the midst of all that, which we're going to be here, we have to keep our faith and our trust in the Lord, because them bringing all these things, this chaos, is so that they can bring in their order. All right. So we have, you know, Lord's willing, this lesson is just, you know, to encourage you to keep your mind focused on the Lord in these times. All right, and I'm going to start with the scriptures. You see on the screen, I'm going to start at Psalm 91. You know, this is always a good scripture to keep in mind. You know, remember, wisdom and knowledge should be the stability of our times. And this devil is going to come with so strong of a deception that it could even deceive the very elect. You know, if it was possible, it would deceive the very elect, because it's not possible. But, you know, some people that maybe believe, you know, or they think they believe now, you know, when Esau brings on, you know, comes in like a flood and brings these winds and these strong rains, a lot of Jake is going to fold, man, you know. But anyways, this is it says security of the one who trusts in Yahweh. So that's the big component of it. Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai, if you don't trust him, then you're not going to be protected, man. If you don't have faith in the Lord, you will not be protected. This is Psalms 91, verse 1. It says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of Yahweh, he is my refuge and my fortress. My power in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. Because you're going to have these different traps that they set in, you know. And I mentioned, when you look it up on World War III, it's not just missiles. You also got biological warfare, you know, economic warfare. That's what they have in these little, what do you, kind of like Cold Wars right now, and proxy wars, you know. But the Lord's going to protect us from that. It says, verse 4, he shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. You see, like I said, wisdom and knowledge should be the stability of our time, you know. But Psalms 17 and 8 says, keep me as the apple of thine eye, hide me under the shadow of thy wings. And that's what we want to do, you know, abiding in the tabernacle of the Lord forever, man, and trust in the covert of his wings. Scripture says that, let me get this real quick, you know, because we are the Lord's woman. Trying to think of where it was at. Yeah, this is Isaiah 32 in verse 2. It says, and a man shall be as an hiding place from the wind and a covert from the tempest, as the rivers of water in a dry place, as the shadow of a great rock in a weary land. You know? So, a man shall be a covert from the wind. So, just like a woman, you know, the Lord give us the power, a woman going to come to us to be a covert. Let me get that word. It just means shelter. Sathar. Covering, shelter, hiding place, secrecy. You know? Yeah, just pretty much protection. You know? So that's what a covert is. Is a covering from the winds. And I'm, like I said, I likened that wind Matthew's or John's 7th chapter. I'm trying to think of where that's at. There's another one that I think of, man. This is ultimately that ticket on the chariot that we want. This is Isaiah 26, verse 20. Come, my people, enter thou into the chambers and shut thy doors about thee. Hide thyself, as it were, for a little moment, until the indignation be overpassed. For behold, Yahweh cometh out of his place to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity. The earth also shall disclose her blood and shall no more cover her slain. So, you know, during that, during this incoming nuclear war, we want to be covered by that, man. And we believe in that. And we trust that. Yeah, it was Matthew 7. Matthew 7 and verse 24 says, therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. And everyone that heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them not shall be likened to a foolish man which built his house upon the sand, and the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it. And Lord's will, I'll do another video, you know, just likening these different these winds, floods, winds, or rain, unto these different things that's there to overthrow your faith. That's why you have to be stand fast in your faith, man. Use this hope as an anchor, you know? And as Esau, that's going to come in as a flood, all right? But back to Psalm 91. I don't know if I finished. Oh, no, that was cool. Because I got, he shall cover us with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. All right, thy truth shall be thy shield and buckler. All right, since I'm still in Psalm, let me get Psalm 61, verse 2. It says, from the end of the earth will I cry unto thee when my heart is overwhelmed. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I, for thou hast been a shelter for me and a strong tower from the enemy. I will abide in thy tabernacle forever. I will trust in the covert of thy wings. Salah. For thou, O power, hast heard my vows. Thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. Wow. And you got people that don't even respect the Lord's name, man. But they're going to want to be covered in them days. I'm telling you. You know, this is Psalm 140, verse 7. It says, O Yahweh, thy Lord, the Lord, the strength of my salvation, thou hast covered my head in the day of battle. Yeah, and we're going to put on this whole armor, man. You know? Got this. We get to Psalms, the 18th chapter. This is it. It says, the Lord prays for giving deliverance, right? It says, to the chief musician, a psalm of David, the servant of Yahweh, who spake in unto Yahweh the words of this song in the day that Yahweh delivered him from the hand of his enemies and from the hand of Saul. And he said, I will love thee, O Yahweh, my strength. Yahweh is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my power, my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler and the horn of my salvation and my high tower. All right. I will call upon Yahweh, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. The sorrows of death compass me. I was going to just read the point, but You know, I'm trying, you know, Lord's will, this is building up, you know, builds up Jake's faith, because faith comes by hearing. You know, and you in these different stories that our forefathers went through, like David, it builds your faith, man, that the Lord's going to be there for us in these times. It says, the sorrows of death compassed me about, and the floods of ungodly men made me afraid. You see that? Floods again. The sorrows of hell compassed me about, the snares of death prevented me. In my distress, I called upon Yahweh and cried upon my power. Come on, man. It messed me up. He heard my voice out of his temple, and my cry came before him, even into his ears. Then the earth shook and trembled, and the foundations also of the hills were moved and were shaken because of his wrath, because he was wroth. There went up a smoke out of his nostrils, and the fire out of his mouth devoured coals. Devoured coals were kindled by it. Was that what I wanted? Oh, let me keep going. He bowed the heavens also and came down, and darkness was under his feet. And he rode upon a cherub and did fly. Yeah, he did fly upon the wings of the wind. All right. Psalm 140:7, O power. Oh, no, I got that. No, Isaiah 46:3. It says, hearken unto me, O house of Jacob, and all the remnant of the house of Israel, which are born by me from the belly, which I carried from the womb, and even to your old age I am he, and even to hoar hairs will I carry you. I have made you, and I will bear you, even I will carry you and will deliver you. Yeah. You know? Let me see if they got, I say, yeah, it's another scripture that just popped in my mind. 16:46. I'm trying to think of where it's at. But yeah, Yahweh carried us, man, you know, since the beginning. You know, he's going, so we gotta trust that he's going to continue to do that, man. Damn, they don't have it. It was talking about, nah, that's not it. Lord's will, if I think of it, if it comes to me, I'll post it in the, is this it? Nah, I'll post it in the thread. Anyway, let me keep going. This is Proverbs 18:10. It says, the name of Yahweh is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. You know? So, you know, like I said, some people don't even respect his name, man. But they're going to definitely call on it, you know, in that day. This is Psalm 27:1, it says, Yahweh is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? Yahweh is the strength of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? And that's the type of confidence that we have to come with, man. You know, it's another one. 2 Corinthians 2. Let me see. No, 1. Talking about the trouble. This is 2 Corinthians 1:8. It says, for we would not, brethren, have you ignorant of our trouble which came to us in Asia, that we were pressed out of measure above strength, and so much that we despaired even of life. So we're gonna be in those moments, man, where we're gonna despair even life, right? But we had the sentence of death in ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves, but in the Most High, which raises the dead, who delivered us from so great a death, and doth deliver, in whom we trust that he will yet deliver us. You see that? So we trust that the Lord will yet deliver us, man. And even then, he has the power to raise us from the dead, man. He has power over death. He created death, you know? This is Psalms 144, verse 2. It says, my goodness and my fortress, my high tower and my deliverer, my shield, and he whom I trust, who subdueth my people under me. This is Isaiah 26, verse 4. Trust ye in Yahweh forever, for Yahweh, and it says Yahweh is everlasting strength. You know, our people, they're going to want to trust in Egypt, man. You go to Isaiah 30 and 31, you know, our people trusting in Egypt, man. And it's going to be to their shame. You know? Isaiah 20 and 7, it says, Psalm 27, some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of our of Yahweh, our power. All right. Yeah, that's pretty much what I wanted. I got a few more, but I'm gonna save it for a different lesson. You know, on our people trusting in the opposite, they trusting in the enemy as opposed to their power, their strength. So, you know, with that, Lord willing, that was edifying. To the next lesson, I want to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Kakadash, and I want to say Shalom.